What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the ChangeSkinX Minecraft plugin. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Customizing your Minecraft account is an extremely important and popular feature in the game since it allows you to personalize your character for anyone to view, but it's not something you can do in-game. If this frustrates you and you wish you could just use a command to change your skin, then the ChangeSkinX plugin is here to help. All you need is a short command which instantly applies their skin to their in-game characters, and with a management system to prevent certain skins from being used, it gives more control on what sees the light of day. Head to ChangeSkinX on CurseForge and then click Files in the top menu. Find your desired game version for this plugin and then select it and press the download button to the right-hand side. Save this file somewhere easily accessible for later, and then you're gonna wanna do the same thing for the same version of Protocol Lib since it's a dependency plugin. You can use the Spigot download page, or if you're using 1.19 or higher, use the devs link that will be linked down below. Next, you're going to head towards your Apex server panel, stop the server, and click FTP file access near the top left. Log in and then enter the plugins directory, and in the top left corner, press upload and drag the files into the upload area on the next page. Wait for these to reach 100%, and once that's done, you can use your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel where you can restart the server. Once that's loaded, join and run the /plugins command in-game to confirm your installation. Once you join the server, you're going to notice a few new commands that are available to use, and as long as you're a server operator, you're going to be able to access these right away. Using them in-game is the main function of the plugin, since you're only going to need one command to actually change skins. But in order to successfully do this, you're going to need another person's username. This plugin does use Mojang servers, so only existing skins are going to be able to be used and not custom ones. There is only one command to use, but a few different arguments to use with it. For example, you can use either a username or the UUID to switch Minecraft skins. In order to use these commands, you are going to have to be a server operator or have the correct permissions, so make sure you have a permissions plugin like Luck Perms to manage them. You might also want to customize the plugin's settings for unique features or disable them. For example, inside ChangeSkinX's configuration, there is an area to permit default skins so players without any can instantly have one when they join. Stop the server and head towards your FTP file access from the main panel and then log in and enter the plugins directory and then click on the ChangeSkin folder. After that, you can press edit to the right-hand side of the config YML file, make any changes, and then click save at the top. After this, you can return to the main panel and restart the server to apply the changes. If you're wanting to avoid inappropriate or specific Minecraft skins, then blacklisting them is required. This is done by enabling the skin permission setting in the plugin's configuration file, and then adding the negative version of the change skin whitelist node in your permissions manager. For example, server owners can block the ability to use Notch's skin with this code. You can also create a whitelist in the same way using these commands in the config files. In cases where ChangeSkinX isn't loading or working, you're going to want to double check that you've installed Protocol Lib. This is considered a dependency for the plugin to successfully load and work in game. You're also going to want to make sure every plugin that you download is the same version of the server you're running. If you're running a 19.3 server, then you're going to need 19.3 plugins to match. If you can't change your skins, it might be due to a permissions issue, so make sure that they're granted access in your node managing plugin. It could also be that there is a blacklist or a whitelist set up, so only certain skins work. If all else fails, it could be an issue with the Mojang servers or the account you're using, so try using both the username and the UUID to see if either one works. If you want to give your players a way to switch their skins in-game as many times as they want, then this plugin is the perfect solution. As long as they have the permissions, they have free reign. But with the ability to black and whitelist skins, you do still have a good amount of control over which skins you see in your world. That's all for this one, and as always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.